Hello friends, this video on mechanical properties of fluids part 6 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos from part 1 to 5 before going ahead with part 6. We will now study a very important concept that is called the hydrostatic paradox. Till now we studied about the Pascal's law. Now, reading Pascal's law without discussing hydrostatic paradox is incomplete. So what is basically hydrostatic paradox? First of all, you just try to think of what it can be by seeing its name. Hydro, that is water. Static, that means something which is at rest. What do you mean by paradox? Paradox generally means something which you see, you feel that it should not happen, but it is actually happening. That means something surprising which is taking place. So here we'll see that what surprising phenomenon takes place with water which is at rest. What do we see here? Let us suppose we have some source from which we make some water enter through this pipe. And we have got three vessels of very different shapes. One is a very thin rectangular vessel. The other one is triangular in shape, and the third one is again somewhat different in shape. So both these three vessels you can see that are very different in shape, but when we allowed some water to enter through this horizontal pipe which is at the base of the three vessels, what did we observe? We observed that the height which water reached in each of these vessels is the same irrespective of their shapes. If you see, for this vessel, the first one, it is a very thin vessel. So the amount of water entered would have been less. Similarly, if you look at this triangular vessel, the width or near its base, the width is quite large. So the amount of water which has entered into this vessel would be large. So the surprising fact which takes place here is that irrespective of so very different shapes, the height which water reaches in each of them is the same. So what makes that happen? Now this is very much related with what we studied just some time back. I told you that pressure at any point of time, that is P1 minus P2 was equal to H rho G, right? This is what we found just before some time. That is, we also wrote it in a different way, stating that pressure at any point is equal to the atmospheric pressure plus H rho G. So that means pressure at any point is basically dependent on the height, right? Because height is the only variable. Here in this case, what do we observe? If you see, pressure at the base level for all the three vessels, that is somewhere around this level. So pressure at this level for all the three vessels is the same. So here pressure is the same at the bottom because the water is coming uniformly from one end and there is no other external force which is acting at the base of any of these vessels. So at the bottom, pressure is the same. Now, when the water rises in each of these vessels, it has to make sure that again the pressure remains the same at the top for all the three vessels. So the water will rise as long as the pressure becomes the same. That is, the pressure at the bottom becomes the same as the pressure at the top. Because I already told you before that any fluid moves only when there is a difference in pressure. So the only thing that determines pressure is height. Now, if we want that the pressure should be same in all the three vessels, that means in all of them, the height through which the water should rise should be the same. So that is why, since pressure is dependent only on the height, therefore, in all these three vessels, irrespective of their different shapes, the height which is reached by the water is the same. So this phenomenon or this experiment is popularly known as hydrostatic paradox. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors
and much more. Thank you once again.